This week's Ask Dr. Durie is a very common question right now during this COVID pandemic. The question comes from several patients who want to know, should I change my treatment to try to improve the response to the COVID-19 vaccination? Because we know that some patients may have poor antibody responses to the vaccine because of the underlying myeloma, which makes them immune compromised, but also because of the effect or the impact of the ongoing treatment. Doctors at different myeloma research centers and treatment centers have discussed this back and forth, and the consensus is that the top priority is to maintain the treatment so that the myeloma comes under control. Because we know that if the myeloma is active and is not coming under control with the treatment, that also increases the risk. And so the top priority is to maintain the treatment to achieve that response that you need, and then think about or talk about what could be feasible after that. The first step, if possible, is to have a response at a level of a very good partial response or a complete response. This would be excellent. And so if this is achieved, you can actually talk to your doctor about maybe spacing out the maintenance in the therapy and see if that could be an opportunity to maybe enhance the impact of the vaccination. Now, there are a couple of types of treatment where we know that there can be a negative impact in terms of the antibody production. One of them is the use of the anti-CD38 monoclonal antibodies, and that would be daratumumab or isatuximab, but also the anti-B-cell maturation antigen, BCMA monoclonal antibodies, which also seem to suppress the COVID-19 antibody production. And so the thing to discuss very, very carefully with your doctor is maybe spacing out so that if you're taking daratumumab once a month, for example, an idea would be to get vaccinated right before you're due for your next dose. So that would be a 4-week gap. Unfortunately, we don't have clear data yet to see what is the impact of that, but it's certainly worth considering. And likewise with anti-BCMA monoclonal antibody therapy. So this is something to think about, but we also are realizing that it may be with the ongoing treatment that the use of the mRNA vaccines, the Pfizer or the Moderna, plus the booster may be able to overcome the negative impact of the ongoing therapy. And so the bottom line here is that this is a very important topic. Do talk to your doctor about it. The first priority is to achieve the best response that you need to do well. That is really the ongoing priority. But if you're doing well, you can talk to your doctor about maybe some minor adjustments that could help improve the antibody response. Just don't rush into it, and be sure along the way to maintain all of the precautions that you need to, including wearing masks and any kind of risky situations and the normal precautions that we've been using these past months.